Slagging off. Hey.
Ooh. Scared the life out of me, mate.
I didn't mean to. Picking up any tips?
I don't think they like the short strays here.
You didn't mind them, did you?
I love this track. Always do well here. Well, used to.
How are you doing, Devin?
Me? Golden, mate. Loving life.
Yeah, sure.
You know what it's like to leave all this behind, don't you?
That's the most difficult thing I've ever done.
Yeah, well, like that. But, I didn't choose this, Caspar. I didn't.
I know.
You came back, right? How's it treating you?
Ups and downs.
How's our old teammate doing?
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't think he's happy here.
He still thinks he belongs in that top team, see? He's never let it go. That's the problem. You know, I could have a word with him. I mean, if you think that might help.
It's all a bit dark.
Yeah. I understand.
No, Devin, I mean it.
Yeah. Scouts on him, mate.
Hey, we need your input on this one.
Did Caspar really want you to talk to Aiden?
I read between the lines. Look, Casper's good at lots of things, but I know people. Yeah, I know how to get in their heads. And I wanted to help Dad, help the team, so...
Leave me alone.
Listen, I'm just saying, mate, if you were such an incredible driver, you wouldn't be a connoisseur, would you? Sorry, it's the truth. No offence.
Well, maybe I won't be here next season.
Dude, you know what your problem is?
Yeah, you.
You think you're better than the team. I remember when Aiden Jackson was just happy to be behind the wheel of an F1 car. We all liked that guy far better than this one.
You never liked me.
No. But Casper did, once upon a time. Oh, you're different now. You think you're too good for the team, your head's stuck in some imaginary big three-seating cloud cuckoo land, mate. No. You have got to drive the car you're in.
You're lecturing me about ego.
A subject I know well.
Oh, right. I get it. So you're allowed to be cocky, but I'm not. Is that it?
There's a difference.
How can there possibly be a difference?
This isn't... This isn't you, mate.
Oh, get lost. Be true to myself. Drive the car I'm in. The wisdom of Devon Butler. Should I be living my best life too?
Just drive the car you're in, mate, yeah? Ciao.
Marine Marina Bay hosted a Grand Prix that briefly ran in the 60s and 70s, but the Garden City re-entered the calendar for good in 2008. We missed it for a couple of years, but it was great to come back to the Singapore Grand Prix. It's a 3.1-mile lap here at the Marina Bay Street Circuit, with 47% taken at full throttle. It's hot, humid, and bumpy around the 13 lefts and 10 rights of mostly slow corners. But we should see speeds of up to 200 miles per hour along the Raffles Boulevard. Let's run you through the driver grid. Well, it's a beautiful night here.
Aidan, you know what you're doing here. Let's lock in and give it everything. Show us what you got. Good job, nice overtake. locate DRS is now available. Behind is 4.3 seconds. You made it look so easy. Approaching the pit window and you're going to be on medium. gap to the car in front is 2.3 seconds. Okay, be aware, the grip levels are going to start falling away soon. Ali's coming in for a stop. Okay, let's go now. Come on. That was a fantastic stop, faster than we were expecting. Pit strategy complete. See these tyres through to the end now. Okay, that's P4. You're into P4. Seconds. Up a place. And that's just 5 laps of fuel remaining. Remaining. We've got enough fuel for 3 more laps.
results are in, there we have it. What a race that was.
The sheer grit and determination shown by some of the drivers out there today, Crofty, was nothing short of incredible.
Elbows out, especially from Aidan Jacks. Loved his race today, and he finally delivered the sort of performance that we know that he's capable of. So whatever they're saying to him over at Codemasters, he seems to be listening to. Welcome then to the podium, our top three drivers. What a great effort from them today in a very difficult race.
Now, Aidan, you have had your ups and downs this season, but tell me, on the whole, are you pleased with your overall performance?
Yeah, I'm really happy with what we've achieved. You know, F1 gets more and more competitive every single day, so I've really given it all this season, and, you know, today I've been able to show a little bit more of what we're capable of.
OK, I'm going to be cheeky, go straight for the jugular. If you had to choose a teammate between Callie and Devon, who would it be?
I guess I'd have to choose Callie. We've had our differences, but I'd take her over Devon any day. Plus, she's clearly the better driver.
Now, Aidan, you have recently hinted that you're not entirely happy at Codemasters. Tell me, is it true?
My happiness is neither here nor there right now. I've got a job to do this season, and I want to do it the best I can.
There's been wild speculation on whether or not Codemasters can even be on the grid next season, so can you tell us more?
That seems like a question for the investors, but no one's funding Codemasters as a charity. They're funding it as a business. And if a business isn't successful, then there's definitely an issue.
Well, thank you for chatting with us. Great to have your time.